The death toll for severe tropical storm Anthem climbs to 13 as heavy rainfall continues to trigger flooding and landslides. The Civil Defense Office notes around 240,000 individuals are affected by the storm. As of 3 p.m. Tuesday, Anthem was located west-northwest of Ilocos Norte. It is forecast to exit the Philippine Area of Responsibility Wednesday morning. Meanwhile, President Marcos Jr. met with the private sector to discuss recommendations related to disaster resilience. Philippine Disaster Resilience Foundation President Butch Maley says Marcos was keen on pre-agreements with local construction companies for debris clearing and road repair operations after disasters. Maley adds they also proposed laying out short-term incentives that could entice businesses to lend a helping hand.
One of our proposals to the president was actually to create these, they're not exactly PESA zones, but to create short-term incentives for companies to invest in areas that have been stricken by disaster. For example, Marawi is still in a very rough patch right now, several years after the conflict. Perhaps if they created an area for no taxes, an area that you could barter goods from overseas, such as cell phones, TV sets, maybe in cars, and create that area there. Economic activity will return to this, to an area like Marawi and other areas around the country that are hit by disasters, because not only local companies, but perhaps foreign companies.
Gas stations may be required to have charging ports for electric vehicles. This is one of the proposals being studied to speed up EV adoption in the Philippines. Jackie Pascual reports.
Electric Vehicle Association of the Philippines.
The Energy Department and the Electric Vehicle Association of the Philippines are now reviewing various proposals to further speed up electric vehicle or EV adoption in the country. One of the proposals eyed is to mandate gasoline stations to also have a charging port. DOE Director Patrick Aquino said they will make a draft proposal this quarter and public consultations will be held.
If you have more than four pumps, We'll put up one. Parang ganon. We'll base it on that because you're also aware na merong mga bulilit stations na isa lang yung ano.
EVAP President Edmund Araga understands there may be safety concerns, but he assures the public putting charging stations at gas facilities is safe and also convenient for motorists who might eat or shop at nearby cafe or retail shops while their EVs are being charged.
Before, there was some issues like how can it may address safety concerns, baka masunog or whatever. But with the standards and with a lot of global standards that being taken place, na-set up for naman talaga yun na na-secure.
EVAP adds, if this is approved, the Philippines will be the first to require gas stations to also have EV charging ports, which will encourage more Filipinos to buy EV. The Energy Department also wants charging stations to be powered by renewable energy. Currently, many charging stations still get power supply from traditional sources.
It will be 100% powered by renewable energy. So that's already in the roadmap. Target short term is 25%, by 2030 half, and then by 2040 and beyond, 100% renewable energy powered.
Another proposal being studied is to have a CARS-light program for the EV sector. CARS, or Comprehensive Automotive Resurgence Strategy Program, offers performance-based fiscal support for vehicle manufacturers in the country. Overall, the DOE is happy with the progress of EV usage in the Philippines. Several stakeholders will join the upcoming Electric Vehicle Summit, where EV companies will showcase many of its new models, including one from a Vietnamese EV company.
Philippines market is one of the key important market for Asia, for VinFast.
We will be introducing a all-new compact electric vehicle that would be priced below 1 million.
A different kind of performance, like how your EVs can be as exciting where you can use it from the road to the racetrack.
Araga added that EVs are good for the weather in the Philippines, even recalling how his EV survived the recent flood.
Nabaha ako using an EV. Walang issue sa akin, kahit kandun siya kalalim. Kasi ang notion kasi baka lumubog o baka pasukin sa loob. Hindi ganun eh.
EVAP hopes more Filipinos will consider getting an EV which is cleaner and more affordable to operate in the long run. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Ride-hailing firm InDrive, which recently relaunched its operations in the country, is aiming to expand to more Philippine provinces as it looks to double its driver base this year. Andrea Taguines with the full story.
Ride-hailing app InDrive eyes to double its driver base in the Philippines from 8,000 to 16,000 by the end of 2024. In an earlier interview with ANC, InDrive Marketing Director for the Asia-Pacific region, Natalia Makarenko, said the company even aims to reach up to 20,000 drivers.
We see the amount of drivers growing every day, right? And it's actually been faster than we expected. And this is a really, really great news for us because it means that the business is getting traction.
The goal to onboard more drivers comes after InDrive saw a 75% increase in ridership over the last 3 months, or since its relaunch in the Philippines in June. That's despite having to let go of what was supposed to be the company's unique selling proposition, its fair haggling scheme, to comply with the regulations of the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board. InDrive's monthly active users also grew by 86%. As a show of support, Transport Group Laban TNVS said it is encouraging all its member drivers to switch to InDrive, which is still implementing a 0% commission rate.
Sinasabi naman natin sa mga drivers natin kung saan tayo kikita ng maayos at kung saan tayo itunuturing na bilang partner, totoong partner at hindi pinapabayaan ng transport network company, dapat doon ang suportahan natin.
We will be looking closely and monitor closely the situation of business growth and development, and of course, we have an open feedback communication with our drivers partners. So this is totally important for us to understand the condition of the people that we're working with, right? So that all of that will be informing our decision on imposing the commission and the timings of doing so.
Makarenko noted that once InDrive begins deducting commissions from drivers' earnings, the rate would be 10% or lower than the rate of its main rival in the Philippines. InDrive currently operates in Metro Manila, Bacolod, Baguio, Iloilo, Butuan, and Cagayan de Oro. It plans to expand its ride-hailing service in Cebu, Davao, and Pampanga. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.